Hello and welcome to Bricks Videos. This is the channel where we answer all your questions related to property buying. In today's video, let us take a quick look at the steps involved in home loan balance transfer. Home loans can be a burden with high interest rates and decade-long repayment timelines. But an easy way to take advantage under different circumstances is by transferring your home loan to another bank. The advantages could be better interest rates offered by other lenders, increased loan tenure, thereby reducing the EMI, and better service offered by other lenders. Additionally, you need not bite a bullet while you transfer your outstanding loan from one lender to another. Follow these steps to ensure you get done with the process with minimum fuss. First step, jot down two or three prominent banks and do a cost-benefit analysis. Compare what would be your savings or losses if you switch to any of the banks. Once you have finalized on the bank, apply for a no objection certificate from your current lender. This should essentially include all documents related to the property in current lender's possession, loan repayment history, the outstanding loan amount, and the current lender's consent to hand over the property documents to the prospective lender on complete payment of the outstanding amount. When it comes to the charges involved in loan transfer, the existing bank may levy prepayment charges on the loan, but no banks and housing finance companies are allowed to levy any prepayment charges on floating rate home loans. When it comes to fixed interest rate home loans, HFCs are not allowed to levy a prepayment penalty if the borrower prepays the loan with the help of one's own funds rather than by borrowing from a bank or a HFC. Additionally, the borrower may also have to pay the processing charges, stamp duty and registration charges for the mortgage to the new lender. Finally, you need to apply for your loan transfer with your new bank, and also you need to mention any additional changes if required in regards to change in EMI or tenure. The new bank will then transfer the balance principal amount to the old bank or issue a check to the new lender, and that is subject to verification and approval from the new lender. Here are a few points to remember. It is always advised that you read every document and all terms and conditions before you apply to a new lender. Ensure that the area your property is located in falls under the purview of the new bank. If not, then your loan might be refused. Evaluate the tenure of your loan and, more importantly, the interest rates offered for the loan by the new lender. This brings us to the end of this video. We hope we have answered your queries relating to this video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below and we respond to every comment we receive. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and share our videos if you like our work, and don't forget to watch our related videos.